Welcome to my channel, Planet with Smells of Writing. I'm going to be doing the daily scripture writing for day 21. And it is going to be Hebrews 4:16. So before I begin, welcome. Please subscribe, hit that post notification bell so you don't miss out on any new videos. Please give this video a big thumbs up, leave a comment, and share the video. That'd be greatly appreciated. So with that being said, for the month of January, we are focused on promises of God. We're reading, writing, praying, and reflecting. And we're already done with this page. Wow. And you can see I'm not done with my soap study. I was working on it last night. I think I have more done. I just got to see because I didn't mark them off here. And then tomorrow will be 2 Corinthians 9:8. It's going by quickly. Okay, so we are done now because today's the 21st. So I am going to put 24. So I still need to catch up here, but tomorrow is Sunday. Today's Saturday, right? I think so. Yeah, today's Saturday. So tomorrow, which is Sunday, I will be doing God Promises to You. So tonight I'm working on this. I have my grandson last night, so I didn't get to finish. I have him all weekend. His mom, I think, will pick him up on Monday or whatever, because Tuesday I have a doctor's appointment. I think it's a mammogram. You know, when you hit that certain age, they want to check everything on you. So we are completely done here. Well, you guys are probably completely done here. I will be finishing this, doing this one today as well, because it's the 21st. So we'll be doing the 22nd with you for God's promises to you. And again, it's only a 4-day reading plan. Then we have two left. Discover God's promises and God's promises for the hungry heart. I don't know what the 9 means. I don't know what they mean by that. It was on there, so I just wrote what it said. The YouVersion app is where you can find this. I should probably put that. I don't know if it's like you or just the YouVersion app. Bible. That way you get to see that. Okay. It's not like it's the King James version, because I know theirs is a little different. It's the YouVersion. So I don't know if it's like you, just like this version. I have to look on there. Or is it you version? So you know. Alright, so we got all that out the way. Oh, as I was saying about the soap study, scripture, observation, application, and prayer. There is a new, it's not new, I shouldn't say new. There's a study out. I see people doing the feast method. And I didn't write the notes down. I have to write them down. So I think I'm going to try, because the soap method is not working for me. Like, I don't do, I'm not like, once I'm done doing this, I do other stuff, like my other devotionals, journaling, things like that. So here, I'm not really, and especially this month, I want to try a different one for next month, maybe Feast. Or there's another one. I think it's ACTS. A-C-T-S. I think it is. There's so many methods out there I want to try. I don't want to keep doing the soap because I fall short. If you see, what is this? December. I fall short on my soap methods. And then I'm like wasting, you know, like spots that I could be writing. See how in the back? So, but I go, we'll go back and do those. I'm never gonna not do it. But I wanna try different methods moving along. So if you have any methods you do, leave them in the comments below. I don't know why I do that. And then another thing is, do you wanna do the book that I showed yesterday, which is the little, it's in my bedroom, the little Bible devotionals? Which seems pretty cool because you could finish that within the year. Devotions, I think it's called. The little Bible. I forgot the, I think it's devotions. Or do you want to do the Matthew? I'm not going to start it now because I figured with everything on my plate for the month of January is busy with doctors, right? So I'm figuring February we can do like reading in Matthew, you know, anything. Just leave it in the comments below. Let me know what you want to do. And, you know, whatever method you use, let me know so that if it's feast, if it's soap, if it's whichever one, or if you don't do it, just let me know in the comments below. If you're interested in doing one, let me know too. So with a lot of letting me knows, let's begin with what we're here for, which is Hebrews 4:16. NIV and She Reads Truth. I like the She Reads Truth Bible. It has so much good information in there. Like, just sitting down, just looking at it, it's like, it's a beautiful Bible. Okay, so 4:16, it's all the way in the bottom. It says, "Let us then approach God's throne of grace with confidence so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need." So right now I have some time to, you know, film. My grandson's asleep. He just fell asleep. Oh, he's cranky when he's not asleep. When he don't get his nap, he cranky. But he fights his nap. I'm trying to let my nails grow, so don't mind my nails. They're turning like that little white tip. So I'm trying to let it grow. But I'm missing something. I used to take the hair, nail, and something else. Vitamins, and it was starting to work. Let's say it again. "Let us then approach God's throne of grace with confidence so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need." So let's go ahead and write that. So how is everyone doing and how is your scripture writing coming along? And again, if you are not caught up, there's no judgment here. There's days I am never caught up. So, and then it takes me a little time to catch up. And that is okay. And I definitely want to give a video out to you every single day with scripture. We need to have faith, you know, scripture in our life. So I love doing this. This is something that I love doing. And I was reading yesterday in a book. When I say I have something, I should show it to you. But in the next video, I will show you. I'll show it to you tomorrow. It was saying if you feel like... Was it a book or did I download something? I think I downloaded it. I might have. But I was reading a book yesterday in, you know, on faith. And it was saying about if you feel like this is a chore, then there's something wrong. No, it's in here. I'm gonna show it to you when I'm done. It was one of the, and I wrote what the guy said or lady said. I don't know who wrote it, but I wrote it as a soap study. If you're feeling like this is a chore, then there's something wrong. You're missing, like, the big picture of it. Okay, so here. We got the observation. We read it. So I'm going to show you that really quick. And then I think it's day 15. Right here. Yes. Okay. So when following Jesus feels like a chore, that is a red flag. That's what I meant by something's wrong. The core of the gospel has been missed. If I am trying to take his yoke, sorry, my writing is sloppy sometimes. I have neuropathy. Yoke upon me while I am still wearing the chains. Why do I want to say change? chains of my sin than I am tormented by the contrast. The weight of the sin will wear me down, while I am fooled into thinking it's the weight of his yoke. The solution, then, is to focus on the gospel daily. So that is why I say that I want to do this daily, because that is my focus, is to do scripture daily, focus on the gospel. So, and then I was reading that when you start, like, I think it's this book I was reading. No, it's the little Bible devotional. So when you start reading and you want to go through a year, start with the Old Testament, the New Testament, and then Proverbs, and there was another one. And I was telling you it yesterday. So if I can remember what that one was, then I can explain it better. But that's how I'm going to start my mornings off, with reading that Bible in the morning, doing the scripture right after that, so that it's still consistent. Try to get my soul study done, or whatever one we pick, and then do my devotional. So reading the Bible, this is how my mom did it every day before she passed. She read the Bible every day. She had her coffee. She used to smoke cigarettes. So she would have her cigarette, she'd have her coffee, and then like she'd had a little routine where she read her Bible on her recliner, and she would do that every single day. She was a stay-at-home mother because she was ill. She had heart trouble. So I'm at home now, so I need to focus on a routine. I was telling my daughter about my grandson and routines, and I need to focus on a routine for my faith. I was saying about him, you know, like he needs to be on a routine when he comes here and when he goes home, that we're consistent, so he's not, you know, like, he don't feel like, oh, they're just putting me here or putting me there. He's always loved. He's always, I mean, he's our heart and soul. So, and then she has another one coming. So my heart's growing bigger and bigger and bigger. All right, so let's read again Hebrews 4. I was going to say 5, but it's 4 because I'm seeing 4 and 5. And I'm like, wait, was it 4? But I'm looking at 5 here. Okay, so 4:16. Therefore, let us approach the throne of grace with boldness, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in time of need. Let's repeat that. Therefore, let us approach the throne of grace with boldness, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in time of need. So I didn't get to read my little Bible devotion today and start that routine. Tomorrow, I will be starting that routine. So even though my grandson will be here, once he's, you know, like he's sleeping and everything, I'm going to start that routine tomorrow. When he goes home is when I will do it in the morning. But for now, because he's here with us for the week, well, the weekend, not the week, because we asked for him to come. And yeah, so thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. If you got anything out of this video, I hope it is that you can start a routine. And if you already have one, let me know what kind of routine you have. But that is how I am going to start my routine. Focusing on the Bible's reading plan for in that little book I have. So that, not that I'm rushing to read the Bible in a year. I do want to, that's one of my goals, is to read the Bible in 1 year. If I don't read it in 1 year, I wanted to read it within the 2 years plan. But with that Bible, you're reading it in 1 year. But if you can't finish, like say it's this page, another page, and you can only get to this page, I don't want to read everything and forget what I read. I want to read it as I can, you know, like focus on it and then move on. So let me know if you have a routine as well. Leave it in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy these videos. I am so grateful that, you know, I have subscribers that, you know, watch my videos, and give it a big thumbs up. Thank you for watching. Talk to you later. Have a good one. Bye-bye.